Okay. Show me.
Hi there, guys. Welcome back to the Dutch Sea Channel. Thank you very much for tuning in. And this here is the CAPRC Dolphin. I recently did a couple of videos on this quadcopter. And this is an ultralight 4-inch FPV quadcopter. Yeah, obviously an FPV quadcopter. But the main thing here is that it is an ultralight and it is a 4-inch quadcopter. Now, the main thing about these quadcopters is that obviously they're very light and therefore efficient, or the air draw is low, so you end up with a long flight time. That is very nice. So I thought while flying and while reviewing this quadcopter, I thought, maybe I should do a build of a quadcopter like this, or maybe try another one. Why not? And one of the 4-inch quadcopters I ran into was the Beta FPV X Knight. So not the X Knight, but Knight. I'll show you a picture. There. That's what it looks like, or that's what it should look like. I haven't had one. Maybe I will end up reviewing the RTF version as well. However, look what I've got. I've got me, well, a box, right? Yeah, and this box contains a frame kit for that X-Knight from Beta FPV. So I'm going to be building that 4-inch quadcopter from Beta FPV. Now, I don't only have the frame kit here. I also have a 4-in-1 ESC. This box here contains 4 motors. This little box contains a VTX video transmitter. I've got me a Runcam camera, and I've got me some propellers. I've got a couple of other small things. However, in this here video, I'm going to take you on a tour of this frame. A show and tell review of this X-Knight 4-inch frame from Beta FPV. So I'm actually expecting it to be reasonably simple. And let's see what we have. We've got a QR code for the manual. I do expect to see an assembly guide in this box. I haven't taken a look yet. And a QR code for their Facebook page. And nicely packaged. I'm not sure if it'll show up in camera well, but we've got the center frame parts here. This will be your stack mount and your canopy mount, I assume. And I'm not sure. Yeah, I haven't had a look at the assembly guide yet. Okay, these are the 3 center frame parts. Then, we've got some documentation. Let's have a looky. Yeah, this looks like an assembly guide for the frame. Yeah, a bill of content and an assembly guide for the frame, which looks to be fairly simple, and it should be, of course. All right, cool. Then, as you can tell, all the arms are nicely packaged separately. 4 arms, obviously. And we've got some other stuff. All right, what I'll do is I'll take everything out of the box and we'll take a closer look. And there you have it, all the parts we received in that box. Now, for what it's worth, I'll have links to all the components I will be using for this build in the description of this video. One thing of note, and you might have already noticed, that this frame does not contain a canopy. A canopy like this, a pod, if you will, a camera housing. And I've actually asked Beta FPV about this, why they don't include a canopy / pod. And they told me, well, we don't know which camera people will want to use. I'm going to be using a nano size camera, but the RTF version of the X-Knight actually uses a micro size camera, so a bigger camera than I'll be using. So therefore, it's simply an optional part. And I will include a link to their original / their stock pod for the X-Knight in the description of this video. Just for a shopping guide for you if you want to build a quadcopter and you don't want to, maybe you don't have a printer. I printed my own. or maybe you don't want to search around, I'll have a link to the original X-Night pod in the description of this video, and that is meant for a micro-sized camera again. Okie dokie, so we've got four arms, obviously. I actually considered adding some spares to my order, but since these are very light quadcopters, we'll see. And then we've got the center parts over here, as I mentioned before. And I was taken a little bit off guard by that third piece. I was wondering what it was for. This is actually an optional part, a battery protector. So you can strap that into your battery strap and have it sit underneath your battery to protect your battery. Maybe make landings or takeoffs easier as well. Yeah, and it's a very light piece. And you've got some landing pads as well, or battery protectors. So this plate over here and all these pads are actually optional. These over here, silicone with double sticky tape things, those are actually the anti-slip mats. And I'm assuming you'll stick those to the bottom of this here plate. Yeah, so actually, let me go and assemble things with a top-mounted camera here. All right, guys, let's get it on. This here is the bottom plate. And hopefully you can see that we'll have countersunk screws from the bottom, which is nice. So your battery won't sit up against screws. And on top of the bottom plate, we'll screw on the arms. And then we've got the top plate. And the top plate has press nuts. Hopefully you can see 8 press nuts over here. Yeah. So that the press nuts are actually at the top of this plate. So, bottom plate, top plate, and arms in between. That's what will happen. And we've got a lot of countersunk screws. And they are, from the looks of it, the same size. Is that true? I think so, yeah. Okay, we'll take 2 of those and run them through one arm, and let me get a driver for that. What size of driver is this? 1.5 millimeter, I think. Yeah, from the looks of it, 1.5 millimeter. And I've actually gone ahead and do I have the correct screw here? Yeah, I do. Okay. The top plate. Yeah, there's no front or back to anything so far. At some point, you'll obviously go ahead and install your flight controller, your camera, and the pod and such. From that moment on, it'll obviously have a front and a back. But for now, our quadcopter has no front or back. So that's what it looks like with one arm attached. And I'm having a look whether I need to install the battery strap at this point. I think I can get away with installing it later on. Yeah, I'll do that. Okay. Next arm. At this point in the build, I'm not going all out tensioning up the screws. Basically, I'm doing a test fit of everything now, right? That's what's happening here. And it'll probably be hard to see for you right now, but all the arms butt up against each other, like so. They form one piece in the end.
So that should eliminate all chance of wiggle room, of play, which is a dirty word in quadcopter, quadcopter land. I'm actually unsure whether a little bit of play in a light quadcopter like this would be a huge problem. But if we can prevent it, I'd say we should. Looks, by the way, like we have a lot of spare screws. We'll see in a second. So far, everything fits well together. Always makes me happy. Last screw of the main build here. Okay, so my assumption was pretty much correct. I can still easily get the battery strap in place. And I'm happy to say that you can either run the battery strap lengthwise or the battery lengthwise or toilet tank style, from left to right. Whatever you prefer, and it'll change the balance and behavior of your quadcopter quite a bit actually. It's actually a thing that's nice to experiment with. Toilet tank style or lengthwise mounting of your LiPo. Again, has a significant impact on the flight performance of your quadcopter, or the behavior, I should say, probably. Hartstikke idee. This indeed weighs practically nothing, and we got a lot of extra screws, and I assume you could use these will probably be used for mounting of the stack and your canopy, and maybe you can opt for these ones and these ones. Yeah, these are long and these are short. That's your options there. And of the screws we now have used, the countersunk screws, we have three spares. I always love seeing spares. We've got a lot of these metal bolts, nuts. And I'm at least going to be using these to secure down the canopy. Other than that, I'm not sure. The manual doesn't really say. So, yeah, this plate, again, is optional. And will I be using it? Yeah, probably. Why not? Again, it'll probably prevent the quadcopter from toppling over when you set it down for a launch. So it'll probably be very convenient to have this plate underneath your LiPo. So yeah, I'm gonna be installing that.
So it kind of goes without saying that a build like this is pretty simple, right? Now, two things I forgot to check or mention, so I'll do it right now. I always check if the carbon fiber is clean so that I don't get carbon fiber dust on my fingers. However, while building this frame, I never got any amount of carbon fiber dust on my fingers. So that's good. That's I guess it's fair to say that this frame is super duper clean, 100% clean. Very, very nice. And then the edges of these arms. Are they chamfered? No, not really, to be honest. They are pretty, I'm not sure if you'll be able to see that in the video, but these arms are pretty much square. Yeah, And not that you'd actually cut yourself on these edges. Maybe there's a minute amount of chamfering just so that you don't cut yourself. But they are definitely square. And the machining feels great. I don't feel any amount of burring on any of these arms or any of the carbon parts. So that is very good, clean, and well, at least well machined. And this here is that battery protector that you'll strap underneath the quadcopter. Very, very nice. So how will the rest of this build commence? You see a couple of holes left, right? Two here, two here, two here, and two here. And those are both for the canopy and your flight stick. So the canopy, at least that I printed, and I'll have a link to this print in the description down below as well, to the Thingiverse source. It's a free design. So a canopy like this will be mounted in the outer holes of this cross, if you will, right? It's as big as that cross, at least the one I'm using, or the one I printed. Then we got a 4-in-1 ESC over here. This one is from Beta FV as well. It's their 20 amp 4-in-1 ESC plus flight controller. I used this exact same 4-in-1 in a previous build and works so far, works very well actually. So this, at least this one, is slightly smaller than that outer cross. Damn it. Like so. I hope you'll be able to see that. So a 4-in-1 ESC like this will be mounted in the inner of these holes. Yeah, so one thing of note, one thing you definitely have to keep in mind is that you don't get risers or standoffs with this frame. For instance, this canopy will probably have to be mounted a little upwards, and you'll need some kind of, maybe I'll print something to go between this cross over here and my canopy. Probably in the same color, obviously, that would look nice. Yeah, so do keep that in mind. If you order up things for a build like this, you will probably need some standoffs and washers and such. I'm sure there are assortments of it. Again, I'll be printing up my own parts here. And to that, I should add that you do get a lot of nuts with this frame. So you probably could actually use those as standoffs. This 4-in-1 ESC that I have here does come with some silicone anti-vibration washers and some nuts and such. So yeah, I might actually not even need much of anything. Let us then have a look what our frame actually weighs. So this is the bare frame. It is 27 grams, which is pretty light for a 4-inch quadcopter frame. And then we've got this optional battery protector, again, completely optional, 30 grams, and we will need a battery strap, and 34 grams. So that's the entire bare frame, if you will. Then with a canopy, we arrive at 40 grams. So this is a canopy without FV camera. And we'll see, I will be doing a build of this this frame. So adding the electronics and such. And we'll see what the end result, the flying weight will be. I'm very much looking forward to flying this quadcopter as it is. Very, very light, at least it's supposed to be light, we'll see. So that is my first look at this X-Night 4-inch frame from Beta FV. This frame is actually also available as a 5-inch. Might be very interesting to build a super duper lightweight 5-inch as well. Yeah, but let's build this one first. So again, this was a first look at this frame and basically also a kickoff for a build project. I'll be doing more videos on this build, the progress of it, and obviously to see if it flies well. Yeah, again, I am very, very much looking forward to flying this quadcopter. Should be super nimble and efficient, long flight time. Should be great. Now, one thing of note, Beta FPV is not really a budget brand. Is that true? I think that's fair to say. However, this frame is pretty inexpensive. $20, I think. Go look it up. There are links in the description and they aren't affiliate links, so I'm not making any money off of it. I'm not being too positive here, I think, about the frame. And maybe the price will have changed by now, but I got my frame for approximately €20 or $20. Yeah, pretty inexpensive, I think, for what you get. And for that, you get an ultra-stiff, frame. There is no play in this frame at all. Flex? No, not really. Maybe if I'd put a lot of... Yeah, I can bend the frame a little bit, but I'd have to put kilos of force onto the frame. I think it's fair to say that this is a stiff frame. And especially for the weight it'll end up being. And that's it. If you are left with questions, hit me up a comment down below. Don't forget to subscribe so you can see the progress of this build. For now, I want to thank you for watching. Catch you on the next video. Bye bye.